You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
As the battle being waged on planet Sadala against Murno now begins to intensify, with Hit having to make the save in protecting both Kaba and Kefla, the situation now involving our heroes being faced off against Murno had now taken an interesting twist, with Hit now having to insert himself in this fight as seen on the previous manga chapter video, in further reassuring Kaba and Kefla. The question going forward is, will Hit become the difference maker in this battle against Murno in finally having to put him down, or will Murno simply now prove to be even too much for someone like Hit to handle, in ultimately resulting in the death of Kefla, Kaba, and Hit by the very end? Now, before we dive any further into this video, if you are new to the channel and of course have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, and want to be kept up to date with everything in regards to Dragon Ball, the Dragon Ball Super manga, and everything involving the Dragon Ball IP, then I do encourage you guys to go on over and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video on this channel, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply stoked, ready, and excited to see what the future holds in regards to the Dragon Ball franchise. And with all that being said, I want to thank you all so much for your support, and let's dive straight into the video. As our story continues with Hit having to be shown making the save in protecting both Kaba and Kefla from Murno, with all of their options now being limited, Kefla went on to ask, "So what exactly are you thinking we do? This guy's like a sponge. No matter how many times we hit him, he just keeps coming back as if nothing even happened to him." As Hit responds, "Well, if we manage to hit him in all the right places, he won't be getting back up. That I can promise you. He's very unusual. I'm not getting a read on his power at all." "What is he?" As Kaba responded, "He said he's an angel from a fallen universe." As only right then and there, Murno had managed to resurface, and as he did with acknowledging Hit now on the battlefield, Murno went on to comment, "Well, well, what do we have here? I know you. Yes, you're the assassin of legend in this universe, aren't you? Now I know. You're Hit. I'm surprised to see you on a planet like this. It's ironic. You are going to be my next victim after I was done here." As Kefla went on to then tell Hit, "Hit, listen. He was baiting us. He's here because he wants to gather as much power and information as he could so he could use it to restore his original body," or whatever it was, with Hit responding, "I see. So it's a trap then. Well then, if he's anything like Vados and the other angels, then our chances of killing him may have been reduced drastically, but that doesn't mean we can't find a weakness to exploit while fighting him. It's a risky gamble, but it's worth taking a shot." As Kaba went on to respond, "We tried everything we could. I think he's hiding more power from us than he's letting off." As Murno went on to clap and applauding Hit by telling him, "I applaud you, assassin. Although it was very unexpected, it's rare to catch me off guard when I'm in the middle of something important. Tell me, was that your time skip? It was actually very good. I would like to see you use it again." And right before Kefla and Kaba went on to make their move, Hit went on to stop them by telling them, "Do not engage. If you go in this fight alone again, you will die. Kefla, follow my lead. You're the strongest we have. As for you, Kaba, I need you to wait here in case you are needed. The last thing we want to do is lose everything we have. Me and Kefla will target his weak points. You're not strong enough to fight him. If you do, then you will die. Wait for my signal." And with Super Saiyan 3 Kefla then acknowledging Murno, she then went on to tell him, "Don't get ahead of yourself, ugly. We aren't dropping dead just yet. But if you think this is going to be any easier for you now that Hit is here, then you've got another thing coming." As Murno went on to respond, "According to whom? I've yet to even try. Go on then. Both of you. I want to see what you can do now that you're both together as one. Feel free to use your time skip all you'd like, assassin. I'll move in first, Kefla says Hit. Stay beside me. When you see an opening, go for it. Got it, says Kefla, and that's exactly what they do, because as they both went on to charge in, Hit went on to ask Murno, so you want to see my time skip, do you? I wonder why that is. You think you can copy it? I know exactly what you're up to, but I'll give you exactly what you've been asking for. Don't blink, or you'll miss the best part. And as soon as Hit then went on to finally use his time skip against Murno, he then went on to punch Murno in the face by telling him, you probably didn't know this, but since the Tournament of Power ended, I did everything I could to improve the length of my time skip in moving much faster and doing much more damage than I was able to do before. So every time you try and break through my defenses, I'm just going to increase the length in which I bind you. And with Hit then getting behind Murno and getting ready to strike Murno yet again, Hit then went on to tell Murno, each strike is going to get heavier as this goes on. It'll only be a matter of time before your body begins to crack. And there's plenty of more where that came from, too. Try not to stumble around as you go and make your way down. Kefla, go for it, Hit says. As he followed through by then having to backhand Murno directly down on the ground, Hit then went on to continue. He's been thrown off his rhythm. Go for it, and that's exactly what Super Saiyan 3 Kefla does, because as soon as Kefla then made her way in, she then went on to tell Murno, oh, I've got a score to settle with you. I told you we aren't going to go down that easily, as she then went on to make contact by punching Murno in the face. Kefla then went on to shout, right back at you, Hit. Don't let up on him, as Hit went on to get ready. Interestingly enough, that's when Hit went on to say to himself, he's probably awaiting for me to use the same time skip I just used on him. I'll have to increase my time. Alright then, let's turn this up a little bit and see what you can do, Hit says. And as Hit yet again went on to use the time skip in freezing Murno in place, he then went on to tell him, as long as I can continue to increase the length and timing of my time skip, there's nothing you can do to break free. I doubt your body will be able to hold up much longer. Your end is near, but then, as soon as Hit then went on to make his way in punching Murno, Murno quickly went on to turn around mid-time skip and grabbing onto Hit's punch by telling him, now hold on, assassin, who said this was going to be the end of me? Did you really think I wasn't going to figure this out? And this goes on to shock Hit, as Hit went on to comment, there's no way he was able to catch on this fast. Well, that didn't take long, now did it, Murno says. It wasn't hard to see what you were doing. It's been millions of years since I've experienced any form of time skipping, so of course it would take me a while to remember its little tricks. Surprised, as he then went on to punch Hit in the face as he went on to tell him, here, this belongs to you. I owe you for getting in my way earlier when the Saiyans were on their last leg. And with Murno sending Hit flying out into the distance, Murno then went on to continue, your time skip works a little differently than some of the others I've seen throughout my time. We angels were taught about time skip many generations ago. It's natural that I would forget, but now that I have seen it and have experienced it once again, it's all that I needed from you. What a shame. There goes your smoke and mirrors. Damn it, no, Kefla says, not again. What the hell is it going to take to get rid of you? As Kefla then went on the attack, each and every single time Kefla went on to throw a punch at Murno, Murno went on to dodge by responding, it would take a power far beyond your simple understanding, if we're being honest. My clones, that is. But as for when my original body is restored, there will be nothing any of you can ever even dream of that can stop me. And with Kefla then proceeding to miss one of her punches yet again as Murno went on to dodge, he then went on to tell Kefla, look at you. Why do you even try when your best efforts of stopping me are getting you nowhere? As he then went on to knee Kefla in the stomach and then later having to kick her in the face, he then went on to tell her, I will punish you for your foolishness before I tear your head off. Such wastes of life do not deserve second chances. And with Hit shown having to stand back up and acknowledging the situation after having to use time skip, Hit then went on to comment, well, there goes my time skip. I didn't think I'd need to use this, but at this point, it's not like I have a choice. When I sensed him move within my time skip, I felt something deeper within him. He's without a doubt hiding a lot more power. It's almost like he's purposely trying to give us hope only to tear it all down. I just need to strike his heart with enough force that it'll stop it from beating. His body shouldn't be able to endure what's about to happen, but if it somehow does, then I'm out of options. Right there, Hit says, there's my spot, as he went on to then unleash one of his deadliest attacks, which just so happens to be that of an invisible strike, and as we get to see how Hit's strike actually went on to make contact in striking Murno in the chest, Murno was taken by surprise by commenting, what? As he did in fact feel every bit of that, as he went on to clinch onto his chest by stating, what? What did he just hit me with? I couldn't see that coming. He struck my heart. You disgusting bastard. As even Kefla went on to notice this, as she went on to ask, hey, he's hurt. You actually hurt him with that one. Do you think this will do the trick? Do you think he's going to be out for good this time? With Hit responding, we'll see. Jiren was the only person to ever survive this attack outside of Goku reviving himself with his own attack. There's no telling, but I got him with a clean shot. His heart should stop beating any minute now, as of course Myrna went on to land on down. He then went on to put this into question by asking, what have you done? What did you strike me with? That couldn't have been your time skip. No, that attack was different. You little worm, you actually hurt me. And as we get to see how in fact Myrno's chest was caved in, he then went on to continue, you targeted my heart, didn't you? You had this plan the entire time. An invisible strike? I've been too careless with you all. You will not live long enough to regret this. As Hit went on to respond, say what you want, but you're on borrowed time. I wasn't expecting for your body to endure this much, but a few more strikes like those and it's lights out. Unless you're lying to us, then you're finished. There is nothing you can do that will stop me from hitting you with one more. This is where you reach the end of the line. One more is all I need. With Hit having to be shown getting into position, he then went on to shout, this fight is over. But then, Myrna went on to activate the powers of Ultra Instinct by further responding to Hit by telling him, no, assassin, this fight is over when I say it's over. And with Hit having to take a momentary pause along with Kefla, as he was in absolute shock, he then went on to put this into question by asking, that glow and that power, it can't be. As Kefla responds, whoa, that looks like that power and form that Goku used to fight me with at the Tournament of Power. So I was right, Hit says. He was hiding more power from us, as Myrna went on to respond, and now the two of you have done it. This should have ended a long time ago, but you rats kept pushing your luck. The only time that is up is the one that's up for you. As Myrna then proceeded to charge directly at them, that's when Hit went on to shout, Kefla, watch out! He's increased his speed! But then, before Hit can even finish his sentence, Myrna went on to punch both Hit and Kefla by telling them, enough! Both of you. I got what I needed from you both. There is no reason to stay here anymore. And now with the knowledge of time skip and your invisible organ strike, that will be enough. Time's up, Universe 6. It's over. As only then, the Beyond Dragon Ball Super Story of Myrna vs. Universe 6 manga chapter special then comes to a close. Now, it would seem as though Myrna now is beginning to get more aggressive in showcasing more of his power, because remember, Myrna wants to take everything he can from Universe 6, from Universe 11, from Universe 7, in gathering and balling everything into one and feeding that to his original body, which of course we are beginning to near ever so closer. So, being the fact that Myrna now is beginning to reactivate the powers of Ultra Instinct in showcasing that against Universe 6 for the first time, the question lingers, what is Myrna going to do? Is he finally going to kill off the Saiyans and Hit in battle, or are we bound to see an unexpected interference that's going to throw Myrna off his game? So of course we are going to be showcasing and posting up the next manga chapter on the channel relatively soon, so all you guys have to do to see it is meet the like goal, which of course the like goal for this video is going to be 5,000 likes. So all you have to do is click one simple button, hit this video up with a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below, and once the like goal is met, we're gonna go on ahead and continue with the series, because right now we are nearing the end of Myrna versus Universe 6. And remember, after this series is over and done with, we have one more before jumping into the story of Myrna's revenge and Myrna's original body having to be completed in battling against the multiverse. And I promise you guys right now, that story is going to be long, that story is going to be bloody, and that story is going to showcase unexpected events, unexpected twists that is going to connect to the other previous stories, such as this one, with Myrna having to gather all the knowledge he has, all the power he has, in using that against everyone. So I want to go ahead and get your thoughts on Myrna now using Ultra Instinct, and if you guys believe that perhaps now Hit and Kefla are going to be placed in a very dire situation that they simply can't get themselves out of. So again, thank you all so much for watching. If you guys are new, hit that subscribe button, tell your friends to subscribe, tell your family to subscribe. The more the better, and I do want to thank you all so much for being here. Thank you all so much for your time. Tune back in for the next manga chapter video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life and taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck's up, Bon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes! Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Mortals, that I'm the biggest Unreal Ant Gaming fan. This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Kakarot!